Welcome to an example of the second fundamental theorem of calculus. If f of x equals the integral of 4t to the second from x to 3, then we're asked to find f prime of x and f prime of 2. Let's begin by reviewing the second fundamental theorem of calculus. If f is continuous on an open interval containing a constant a, then for every x in the interval, the derivative with respect to x of the integral of f of t from a to x is equal to f of x. Looking at the integral, notice how the lower limit of integration is the constant a, and the upper limit of integration is the variable x, the same variable in which we're integrating with respect to. So to find the derivative of this integral, we simply substitute x for t in our function f. So for given this integral is equal to f, and we're asked to find f prime of x, that means we want to find the derivative of this integral with respect to x, which means f prime of x would be equal to the derivative with respect to x of the integral of 4t to the second from x to 3. But looking at the limits of integration in our integral, notice how the lower limit of integration is the variable x, and the upper limit of integration is the constant 3. This integral does not fit the form given by the second fundamental theorem of calculus. We need to change the order of integration here before we apply the second fundamental theorem of calculus. So for a quick review, remember the integral from a to b is equal to the opposite of the integral from b to a. So we can rewrite this as f prime of x equals the derivative with respect to x of the opposite of the integral from 3 to x of 4t to the second. And of course, we can go ahead and factor this negative out and write f prime of x equals the opposite of the derivative with respect to x of the integral from 3 to x of 4t to the second dt. And now using our theorem, we can easily find the derivative of this integral. F prime of x is going to be equal to the opposite of, and now we simply substitute x for t. So f prime of x is equal to negative 4x to the second. So f prime of x equals negative 4x to the second. Therefore, f prime of 2 is equal to negative 4 times 2 squared. 2 squared is 4. Negative 4 times 4 is negative 16. But I also want to take the time to find f of x by evaluating this integral and then finding the derivative to verify our work is correct. Let's go and do this on the next slide. So again, we'll first find f of x. So we'll find the antiderivative of 4t to the second. That would be 4 times t to the third divided by 3. We'd evaluate this at 3 and then x. Let's simplify this first. We'd have 4 thirds t to the third. So we'll first substitute in 3, and then we'll substitute in x. Substituting in 3, we'd have 4 thirds times 3 to the third minus 4 thirds x to the third. This will just be a constant. 4 thirds times 27 would just be 36. And then we have minus 4 thirds x to the third. So if f of x is equal to 36 minus 4 thirds x to the third, let's now find f prime of x. Well, the derivative of 36 would be 0, and then we have negative 4 thirds times the derivative of x to the third, that would be 3x to the second. And notice how this does give us f prime of x equals negative 4x to the second. So the result is the same, but of course, it did take a lot more work. I hope you found this helpful.